El Roctágono presenta.
Just wanting to learn more, I went back and already watched the fight 100 times and picked myself apart, and me and my coaches are figuring out what I need to work on for the next one. I think you always enjoy the victory, especially initially. I made sure I enjoyed the victory for a good week, and then you go back in and you get ready for the next one. You get such an adrenaline rush fighting that you look for the next time you can have that adrenaline again, and you want to do everything you can to improve. Definitely alpha male, that's where I belong. Uriah was a huge, huge help for that fight camp. We did a lot of things where we did individual technique sessions with just people so you could share knowledge with high level athletes. So I got to learn a lot from him, and I incorporated actually like almost everything we learned in that technique class in the fight. So I got to see how just that extra time really breaking things down improved myself. There's a few that come consistently. Luckily for me, actually, Martin Campman brought in a girl named Sarah who was from Holland, and she was a great look for me before Felice. She's a stand-up fighter. Felice was known as to be a stand-up fighter, so it felt really good to have that look before the fight. And we do have other Cynthia Calvillo. She's another standout fighter from our gym. So we do have girls, but it's nice to train with guys too. Would you tell the UFC a no? So I'm gonna trust the UFC, whatever they say, I'm gonna go with. And I think that they obviously want to see the best for all of their athletes, and I'm gonna just continue to grow. You guys haven't seen my best yet, and I'm gonna continue to grow for a very long time. Oh, that's huge. I think it's amazing that women are really breaking through and being a standout in the community, and I think that it's gonna be huge. Rhonda still I don't think she's peaked yet, and I'm excited to see where else she can take it, and excited to see where other female athletes can go. You know, actually, I did have someone message me on Facebook saying they apologize for being really mean to me in high school, and they feel really bad. And you know, those are the things that it really feels really good that people would go through and say that. And it feels good to see that I have grown from it, and it is a part of who I am, and I wouldn't change anything for the world because it has made me tougher. I would love to. You know, I've had a lot of opportunities come just from being a part of the UFC, and I am really fortunate that I get to be on such a huge platform. And of course, I'm going to focus on my fights when they come, but if I can do those things on the side, that would be great.
Búscanos en Facebook, síguenos en Twitter, y encuéntranos en eloctágono.com.